Okay, so starting out, I just want to say that Orchid Academy is a good school, and I'm really happy I chose to go here instead of Rigetti, because I don't think I would have been nearly as decent of a person if I did so. But what was more important to me is the things that I learned by myself going to school here, not just what I was taught by teachers or taught in class. It was my own pursuit of education that I really learned from, like things that I was passionate about. As far as teachers go, the teachers here are pretty great. I know there's some out there that are a little bit of goofballs, but they're still great teachers. Like, I still like spending time with them, being in their classrooms, even if they're not the best teachers. A few of the teachers that have made the most impact on my life have been Miss McManus, because not only did he teach the film program, but he really tried to go out there and get like real applications. Like, I've gone out and filmed on this ranch with him. He always tries to find stuff for us to do. Like, it's not just in class work. He's looking for real applications for it. As much of a hard ass as he is, Mr. Virch is a really good teacher. He's really passionate about what he does. He cares about government, which is something that not everyone can do, and he really teaches it well. He's great at that. And I want to thank Miss Eubanks for being a creative teacher. Most teachers wouldn't let you do a month long of life hacks, which is really a lot more useful than a lot of the stuff we've been learning these past few months of school. It's real life applications of stuff, and it gives people like me a chance to teach other people too who don't have as much knowledge in a certain category, and we're sharing knowledge and learning real things that's more useful. Like, school is very important, but it's also important to get your own dose of what's needed in life. The fact that our school is smaller than most is, I think, a good thing, because it's a more personal experience. Whenever I have a problem, I walk into the counselor's office, even if it's annoying and I ask them 100 questions, they're going to help me out. It's not going to be a problem most of the time. And if I was at a bigger school, a different school, it would be a lot harder to find things out. I know at most schools, they don't give you a whole day to apply to Hancock. You have to wait till after school. You don't have counselor help unless you really go out and seek it. Our school really makes sure that you're on task and doing what's best for you. And also, it's the Hancock application process is not hard, but it's not easy. You're going to need some help if you've never done it before. And I think the fact that the counselors were so involved in that is just really great. And having a smaller school just gives you more personal feel. I was able to connect with different teachers more because they can actually like learn your name and learn what you care about. It's more about yourself. Also, going into Orchid Academy, they did have the whole, you need to go to a four-year college, you need to go on this certain path to become. But I think over the past few years, they've really, the mindset has kind of changed. I know most kids are going to Hancock, which is great. It's cheaper. A lot of kids can't afford to go to a four-year university, myself included. So the fact that going to Hancock is accepted, and that we can choose what to do with our college education and not be judged about it and actually be given good opportunities is a great thing.
Ayo. I wanna talk, I wanna call you and talk. I wanna walk to your front door and knock. After I stop, my vehicle drive to your city, cause we live an hour apart. Land at your driveway and put it in park. Then do the third line of this verse. Then back to my house and we pack up our bikes and we ride through the park, chase the sun. God, that's all I want. Other than air, oxygen and financial freedom. Yeah, I want your company. I need your company. I want you to want for me. I can't maneuver without you next to me. It's so complex to me. What do you need? Do you need bread? Do you need this? Do you need to be alone? I can wrap this up in the fucking Wednesday.
Okay, so starting off, what I've learned about myself. I've learned that I don't know enough about myself yet to really make any big life decisions. I don't know really what I like, what I care about. There's little things, but I couldn't tell you what kind of person I want to be and what I want to do with the rest of my life. And obviously it's high school. I've learned a lot about myself over the past 4 years, and I've changed a lot, and I feel like it's been in good ways. But I did learn a few things. one of the most important things is self-discovery, finding out what you care about, what kind of person you want to be, what you want to do for the world, what are you going to do that's going to help the world. It's important for me that I make an impact on other people's lives, even if it's very minor or not a lot of people care. It's, you're here for a reason, you might as well use it for good. Don't waste your life. I've learned about other people is that you can't be around people who don't share the same interests as you, at least a little bit, or else either one of you is going to start changing to the point where it doesn't work anymore. I've had plenty of friends where we hang out, but it's just as you grow older, you start actually learning what kind of person you are and what you care about, and it's healthy to not break those friendships off, but realize that you guys are going down different paths, and you don't have to be best friends. You can still keep acquaintances, but keep people close to you that really care about what you care about, because they're going to understand you better. You can't understand somebody if you don't understand the things they love or the things they take value for. But at the same time, I need to find more, just go for more opportunities, stop being scared to do things, because when you put yourself out there and you really just say, what's the worst that could happen? That's when you're going to have the best experiences of your life and maybe make the best friends that you have. But that's it.
So wrapping things up, I just want to say that I'm really happy I ended up going to Orchid Academy. It's a great foundation for my future, I guess you could say. I made a lot of good friends, and through that I got to go on a lot of cool adventures and learn a lot about myself. So thank you. And I'm excited for the future. There's so much to be excited for. There's so much past high school. I know people say high school isn't everything, but I think it's good to have a good baseline to start with, and I'm glad that I actually have something to look forward to. So thanks to everyone that's been by my side throughout my journey, and thank you for taking the time out of your day to watch this video. Peace.